Very good morning. So what you are seeing is a building which controls the global health. It is none other than World Health Organization. So you are seeing the World Health Organization, which is located in Geneva, which is in Switzerland. Okay, so let's learn something about World Health Organization. So you know United Nations, which is formed immediately after the Second World War in 1945. So this World Health Organization, it is an agency of United Nations, but it is very autonomous body. The World Health Organization is autonomous body, which is formed in 1948, April 7. Actually, United Nations formed in 1945, but World Health Organization, which is formed in 1948, April 7. So, as I told you earlier, its headquarters in Geneva, Switzerland. So, which controls the world health. Literally, it controls world health, as it has a significant role in every country's health situations. So, in recent times, we are seeing the corona pandemic, and every day in newspapers we come across the word World Health Organization and its suggestions for every country, its comments regarding the outbreak and its preventive measures regarding the vaccine and some other disputes which is with America or China. So it has a significant role, and there should be a significant role from the WHO on every country's health matters. So its role is directing and coordinating the health matters in public health worldwide. So this World Health Organization, it has two components. One is the World Health Assembly, which is also known as parliament. So every country sent one member in this parliament because it is a representative of that country. So almost 194 members will be there, which are the delegates of every country. So each country will send one member to the World Health Assembly. Okay. And this Health Assembly appoints one Director General, and his tenure is 5 years. And the current Director General of WHO is Dr. Tedros Adhanom, was appointed in 1st July of 2017, and the next person will take over on 1st July of 2022. So the Director General period is always 5 years. The current Director General of this Health Assembly is Tedros Adhanom. He's from Ethiopia. And our country has a Deputy Director General for the first time. She was also appointed in the same date as a Deputy Director General of WHO, Dr. Soumya Swaminathan. She was a part of ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research. Now she is taking charge of Deputy Director General of WHO. So that is happening first time an Indian member is becoming a Deputy Director General of World Health Organization. So this is somewhat like a parliament. So this is World Health Assembly, the parliament of World Health Organization. This will be chaired by the Director General, and there will be members from 194 countries, and these meetings will take the health decisions of many countries and the common decision of world health. So other than the Health Assembly, the second component of WHO is Executive Board. So the executive board consists of only 34 members compared to the parliament, which has 194 members. They are being selected for a term of 3 years, but the parliament, the tenure is 5 years, but the executive board, the 34 members will be re-elected every 3 years, and they take the core decision of WHO. So you can see this is executive board, which has very less members compared to the parliament. Okay, so the parliament has 194 members, whereas the executive board has just 34 members. They will be re-elected every. And the last component is the secretariat. So it is like the functioning, the main functioning part of day-to-day functioning part of World Health Organization, which has almost 8,000 health and other experts and other supporting staffs. So which is the implementing part. So the decision will be taken by the parliament and the executive board, executive assembly, and it will be implemented through these people. That is secretariat. Almost 8,000 staffs are working in the secretariat, which has 6 regional offices. So the 6 regional offices, it is the allocation of work or the dissemination of the work throughout the world through these regional subcenters. So each part of the world is handled by these regional subcenters. So it is widely distributed along the globe. So while seeing the African region, it is located in Congo, the United States in Washington, the Southeast Asian region, which is in New Delhi, India, and the European region, which is in Copenhagen, Denmark, and the Eastern Mediterranean region, the office is located in Egypt, Cairo, and the Western Pacific region, which is located in Manila, Philippines. African region, which is located in Brazzaville in Congo. So these are the regional headquarters which directs the WHO World Health Organization's implementation, the work implementation through the staffs, which is located in regional subcenters. So I repeat, the 6 regional offices in African region, it is in Brazzaville, Congo, in the USA, that is in American region, which is in Washington, USA, Southeast Asian region, which is in our country, New Delhi, in European region, which is in Copenhagen, Denmark, in Eastern and Mediterranean region, which is in Egypt, Cairo, and the Western Pacific region, which is in Manila, that is in Philippines. So what they do, this WHO's basic work is prevention and control of specific diseases. Like, you know, we are controlling corona disease with the help of WHO, and they develop comprehensive health services for each country, and they stress on family health, environmental health, biomedical research, health statistics, because you get the official data or reliable data only from the World Health Organization regarding the health matters, and the literature assembling and information cooperation with other organization to improve the health of people. So these are the World Health Organization's work. As we all know, we are going through the corona pandemic. The nurses and midwives are doing a great job in helping people to come out of coronavirus or the COVID-19 disease. So the World Health Organization this year dedicated the theme of World Health Day as support nurses and midwives because of their immense support for the people for recovering from the COVID-19 disease. So I just recap the World Health Organization, which was started in April 7, 1948. So its main goal is to coordinate the health activities around the globe, which has 3 parts. Basically, one is the Parliament or General Health Assembly, which has 194 members. Then the 34 members of Executive Board and 8,000 members of Secretariat. So which has 6 regional sub offices around the globe. And so that's all about World Health Organization. So the World Health Day is April 7 this year. It's dedicated to the nurses and midwives. Thank you.